Economic abuse is another tactic on the power and control wheel. This particular tactic really derives from this notion that men have, something they've told me time and again in the class that I work with them at, is that money is power. And if you control the money, you control the house. And I found that kind of an interesting idea. So I asked this guy, if money is control, what happens when you don't make the money? What happens when she makes the money and brings it all home and you are unemployed and don't have any income coming in? And he said, well, yeah, I still have control, because then when she brings the money home and deposits in the account, I have the debit card and I have the checkbook and she doesn't get access. So it really didn't, initially it was, if I make the money and it's my money, then I get to control it. But then when posed with the idea that, well, what if you're unemployed, you don't make the money, then who gets to control it? Well, she still doesn't get to, because ultimately he sees this is a one way to control his partner's movement, what she buys, her autonomy. Taking money from his partner is a way to remove her ability to move freely in the world, which is his goal. So this idea that if you control the money, you control the house, is something that men really hold strong to. If they give her money, if she has access to resources, then she has access to leave. And this is one way in which they can isolate her, control what she buys, controls where she goes, because she doesn't have access to the funds to do those things.